Hi, I'm Dr. Nick Whitney, and I'm a senior scientist at the Anderson Cabot Center for Ocean Life at the New England Aquarium. My favorite endangered species is the small-toothed sawfish. These are a species of ray closely related to sharks that were the first marine fish to ever receive protection under the U.S. Endangered Species Act. My favorite memory of working with the species is from a few years ago when I got to tag my first juvenile sawfish in the Peace River, Florida, working with colleagues from the Florida Fish and Wildlife Commission. We were putting accelerometers on their fins to measure their activity levels, and we found that they were more active at night than during the day. And they're probably feeding at night in the main stem of the river rather than up in the creeks. What can people do to help endangered species like the small-toothed sawfish? Make sure you pick up any old pieces of net or other fishing gear that you find in the ocean, because entanglement around their saws on abandoned fishing gear is a huge threat to them. You can also support policies that protect shoreline habitats, since these animals come in very close to shore, especially when they're small. Thanks for your help, and thanks for taking some time to appreciate some of our amazing endangered species on Endangered Species Day.
Hi, my name is Amy Warren. I'm a research assistant at the Anderson Cabot Center for Ocean Life at the New England Aquarium, and I love fin whales. They're an endangered species, and they're actually the second largest animal in the entire world. I think fin whales are really special because they're really beautiful creatures. Even though they're 60 to 70 tons, they move really gracefully through the water. But the cool fact about them is that they can actually swim 25 to 30 miles an hour at times if they want to. Something you can do to help threatened fin whales is just shop locally. Reducing shipping across our oceans is a great way to reduce ocean noise and just general effects on all the animals that live in the ocean. So if you can just shop locally, also a benefit to that is helping your local economy. Thanks for your help.
Hi there, my name's Matt Thompson. I'm the Aquaculture Project Lead at the Anderson Cabot Center for Ocean Life at the New England Aquarium. I study sustainable seafood, particularly seafood that's been raised on farms, hence aquaculture. Now, the aquarium believes that sustainable seafood should minimize its environmental impacts, including those on endangered species. These can include things like whales or sea turtles becoming entangled in fishing gear, or predator controls used on fish farms, things to prevent birds from diving in and eating the fish or the shrimp that's being raised there. Two other amazing ways that aquaculture helps endangered species include farm-raising species that may be becoming endangered due to overfishing, or to help raise animals for restocking programs. We can breed animals in hatcheries, release them into the wild, and help rebuild populations that way. Some ways that you can help are to choose sustainable seafood from vendors with a stated commitment to sustainable seafood, and look for seafood that's been eco-certified by groups like the Marine Stewardship Council, the Aquaculture Stewardship Council, or the Best Seafood Practices certification schemes. So thanks for listening. Have a great and impactful Endangered Species Day.
Hi, my name is Kelsey Howe, and I'm a research assistant at the Anderson Cabot Center for Ocean Life at the New England Aquarium, and I study the critically endangered North Atlantic right whale. There are only about 350 North Atlantic right whales left, which obviously is not good. But because there are so few, we get the opportunity to know each of them by a name or number, and sometimes even by sight. That's one of the reasons I enjoy studying right whales so much, because we get to know them as individuals, including their life history and their family trees. I've gotten to see young newborn calves off of Florida in the winter, and then seen the same much larger calves months later on a boat in the Bay of Fundy. We get to watch them grow up, and in some cases, go on to have calves of their own. One of the main reasons why North Atlantic right whales are so endangered is due to ship strikes. One of the ways that you can help is if you're out in the water, keep an eye out for whales so that you can avoid accidentally hitting one. Sometimes they aren't easy to see if they are resting at the surface or feeding just below the surface. And please follow the seasonal mandatory and voluntary speed restrictions that are in place all up and down the coast. These restrictions are meant to make lethal ship strikes less likely and less deadly. And if you don't own a boat, spread the word and tell everyone you know who does have one. Thanks for all your help, and happy Endangered Species Day.
Hi, my name is John Mandelman, and I am the Vice President and Chief Scientist in the Anderson Cabot Center for Ocean Life at the New England Aquarium, where I study and love sharks, some populations of which have been very negatively impacted by human activities, unfortunately. One of the species we work with is the sand tiger shark, which is a popular species to be displayed in aquariums, but is protected in the wild. So if someone catches one while fishing, they must release it with minimal harm. Something I'd like people to know about the species is that while it looks pretty fierce with its menacing teeth and scary expression, in reality, it is very calm and passive. Like other sharks, sand tigers are often caught by accident. And then when people are excited or because they lack awareness around this catch, they pull the shark out of the water onto a beach or onto a boat to take photos or videos. You can help the sand tiger shark and other protected or endangered species by using best available guidelines for safe handling and release, including minimizing time in the air and keeping the animal in the water whenever possible. And please tell your friends about this too. Huge thank you for your help and happy Endangered Species Day.
Hi, my name is Jessica Redfern and I work at the New England Aquarium where I lead the EcoMap program. And I wanted to tell you today about one of my favorite species, the blue whale. And I have loved blue whales since the first time I saw them at sea. They are enormous and the color of their skin above and below the water is beautiful. And there's nothing quite like their tall, towering blow when they exhale. And I spent a lot of time trying to understand where we expect to find blue whales. So when I came to the East Coast 2 years ago and learned about our Northeast Canyons and Seamounts Marine National Monument, I thought, wow, that seems like blue whale habitat. But they hadn't been seen there before until in the winter of 2020, the EcoMap aerial survey team flew one of our surveys and found blue whales there. And that was so exciting to me. To help protect blue whales and other endangered marine species, I think we all need to be conscious about the seafood we're eating and do our best to buy seafood that's sustainable. Thanks for all you're doing to help protect endangered species.
Hi, my name is Dr. Ryan Noddick. I'm an assistant scientist at the Anderson Cabot Center for Ocean Life, and I study oceanic white-tip sharks, a critically endangered species that has been overfished and whose global population has been reduced by upwards of 98%. And what makes this species particularly special is that if you roll the clocks back not that long ago, they were actually one of the most abundant sharks roaming our open oceans. And so the research we're doing here helps with conservation efforts for this very important species that has played a major role in our ocean's ecosystems. Now, each of you can help endangered species like oceanic white tips by raising awareness and educating others about the importance of these animals and supporting policies that promote their conservation. So, thank you for doing your part to protect these endangered species so that they too can be around for many, many generations to come.
Hi, my name is Philip Hamilton. I'm a senior scientist at the Anderson Cabot Center for Ocean Life at the New England Aquarium, and I study the North Atlantic right whale, of which there are only about 400 left. One of my first memories of right whales came in the winter of 1987, when we'd seen a right whale fluke way in the distance, and we idled over in our small boat to wait for it. And I was sleepily staring into the water. It had been a long, long morning already. And we're waiting for the whale to come up. And looking into the dark water, I suddenly saw this black fluke rise up just into view and then pulse down and disappear. And we never saw that whale again. That was the only sighting of it. And the mystery of it, the grace, the beauty, the stillness stayed with me forever. Really remarkable. Right whales are entangled at an alarming rate in ropes from fishing gear. And one thing you can do to help is to ask your restaurants, ask your local stores where they get their seafood and whether or not the seafood is captured in a way that does not harm marine mammals. And by doing that, you'll educate them about the problem and you'll help save right whales. So thank you for your interest in right whales and for caring, and happy Endangered Species Day.